opportunity to meet all the eminent people who have gathered here too. When I first saw her book, I just started glancing through pages, and I realized that for the first time in almost 20 years of my association with this as a researcher, I saw a critical analysis element which was lacking for several years. I have not seen such a critical analysis anywhere earlier, which has been done from internal as well as external point of view. So from that point of view, I was really interested to know what it is. And therefore, we decided that we will review this, and I edit this journal called Journal of Ayurveda and Integrative Medicine, which is a free downloadable journal published by Institute of Ayurveda and Integrative Medicine. And this book review actually has received lot of downloads, you know, so people are actually reading it, and that is the first sign that how much of interest people have in knowing the critical review status of this sector. As she has rightly divided this book into six different chapters, starting from history. And very rightly she has not gone into the all that history starting from Dhanvantari, but what history she has covered is very, very relevant what is today. Second chapter, very, very correctly, and I must appreciate that vision she must have put in, she has put research as a second chapter. I must tell you that many eminent thought leaders globally, especially in India, like Dr. Valiathan, when we talk to them, they have been saying this for years together, that India, if at all we want to make any significant impact at a global level in medical sciences, it can be done only through traditional knowledge system. Because on a knowledge curve, if we talk about biomedicine, we are here somewhere as compared to the world. But as compared to traditional knowledge, we are much at higher level. And so it is really important for us to take that and give a boost so that we will be able to get a leadership position. Now, talking this is one, but actually bringing it in practice is not very easy unless you have this kind of a critical analysis which comes in front of us. I must also tell you that as a biologist, basically a pharmaceutical biologist, it is very, very difficult today in a global level to have new ideas. We may talk about genomics, and I have worked also a lot on genomics. To come out with substantial new ideas, I am convinced, so as many other scientists, including eminent like Dr. Valiathan, that Shastra can give new leads to science. Earlier, our point was science should be utilized to prove or disprove Ayurveda or Unani or Siddha or whatever. And we are challenging this. We are saying that actually the richness of the knowledge in our systems is so much that it can give lead to the new ideas and can help actually the modern biomedicine or biology to fast forward at a global level to take this leadership. I found that germs of those ideas are there in her book, because that book very, very critically, and I must appreciate that it is not easy when she talked about, and you must read what she has written in her recommendation and observations, it is not easy to criticize coming from government that what kind of a research is going on in our country, challenging it, questioning it, and also giving pointers how can you improve it. Mrs. Shailaja Chandra has done a great job.